In the mood for a teardown? Here's the Amazon Fire TV Cube, the first hands-free TV streaming device thanks to Alexa. How do you get into a shiny cube with no screws or obvious point of entry? Well, we have a hunch that the Fire TV is built just like an Amazon Echo, so that means prying up the rubber base and finding some deeply recessed T10 screws. These screws are deep down some very narrow channels, which gives us the perfect opportunity to use one of our drivers from our ProTech screwdriver set. With the four screws removed, the outer case lifts right off, and so does the built-in 1.6-inch speaker that allows you to interact with Alexa even if the TV is off. Speaking of the case, while it may look like a solid black cube to the naked eye, our infrared camera proves it's actually transparent to IR light, allowing the beams of the IR blasters inside to project out. Underneath the speaker is the motherboard, which is connected to the upper portions of the Fire TV Cube by a few cables. On the board, you can see the six multi-directional IR blasters that allow you to use your Fire TV Cube to control other devices in your living room. And underneath some shields, we find the 16 GB of SanDisk-made flash storage and the Amlogic quad-core ARM Cortex A53-based system on chip with a Mali 450 MP3 GPU. We're left with a large metal heatsink that the antenna cables are soldered to. Separating this block from the remaining components is a challenge, as it does require a decent amount of force, and the soldered cables are connected underneath a plastic frame, preventing us from disconnecting them first, risking ripping the delicate cables. The last board in the Fire TV Cube is home to both Alexa's ears in the form of 8 microphones, some flashy visible light LEDs, and the physical buttons that control Alexa's volume and deactivate the microphone. With our Amazon Fire TV Cube completely disassembled, it's time to talk repairability. The Amazon Fire TV Cube scored a 7 out of 10. And here's why. On the upside, the majority of the device is held together by standard Torx screws. The device construction is simple and straightforward to disassemble. On the downside, antenna cables are soldered to the heatsink and the connectors are hidden behind a plastic frame. The potential for ripping one of these cables is high if you're not careful during disassembly. And finally, all the ports are soldered to the motherboard.